Hi guys, today I'm going to share with you 10 really cool effects and plugins which I use in Final Cut Pro 10. It is my favorite tricks with which I work 99% of the time when I edit my YouTube videos, weddings clips or commercial videos, and which you can also start to use without any problems and make your video better, more interesting and professional. But before we get started, as usual, I just want to say thank you for attention to my channel, I really appreciate that. And if it's the first time you're here, my name is Vlad and I will be grateful to see you on the next videos, so don't forget to subscribe. And let's not drag this out and start with the first simple built-in effect which I like to use in my videos, is Handheld. Really cool effect which imitates handheld shooting of camera for your clips. When you have only one camera with one focus range and you want to make your video more interesting and various, you can cut next part of the clip, crop it a bit and add this effect to make feel that there is another camera which also recording you. It makes your video more interesting to watch and look more professional, like an interview. Adjust it up to you and use it. The second effect which I use in each of my videos is custom LUT. I'm pretty sure that you know how it works, I have made a lot of videos about it. If not, it is a tool which can help you not only to use additional presets, colors and cinematic LUTs, but also gives you opportunity to convert your flat footages to Rec. 709 color space. With special LUT depends on type of your picture profile. I mean S-Log, V-Log, HLG profiles, etc. If you want to know more about how to convert flat picture profiles, please check this video. Here you just need to choose your custom LUT from the folder in your computer and add it with necessary level of mix. You can find a lot of free in charge cinematic LUTs in the internet, or you can find by following the link below the video a bit free LUTs from me. The third important tool which I always use is Draw Mask, or simply Mask. This tool has a very wide range of applications, from cutting different subjects on the frame, color grading of particular parts in shot, selecting objects to making seamless transition like I did in my previous video, how I made my B-roll. In addition, you can also add additional effects on your draw mask to make another effect on it. Trust me, it is all about practice and your imagination. After, you'll find a lot of ways how you can use this specific tool in your clips. Enormously useful effect. The next one effect is Keyer. If you occasionally work with green screen footages, then you definitely know about its existing. This tool needs for separating subjects from the green screen footages. Actually, it could be other colors, but in most cases it is green. It works incredibly good, just drag this effect into your green screen clip and that's all. Let's go ahead, the Sharpen and Gaussian effects. Very simple but very useful tools which you can use in different ways. All depends on your imagination and creativity. For instance, you can use combined Gaussian with Draw Mask. Let's copy and pick up the clip. Then on the top clip, let's select me with the help of Draw Mask. And drag Gaussian into the lower clip. Let's adjust amount blur to plus minus 12 and voila! We have got cool artificial bokeh in our clip. If you want to make your clip more sharper, for example you're editing some project and you have different quality of footages, drag sharpen on your bad quality footages and make it more detailed. But make sure to be careful with the amount, don't go overboard. Until 1:3 will be more than enough. The Vignette. Another cool tool if you want to make accent on the main subject in your video. Drag it on the clip and customize it up to you and to your clip with darken. And here is, you are getting this atmospheric look. Number 7. Overlays. Overlays is a great way to make your videos look a bit more interesting and atmospheric as well. So how to add overlays on our clip and use it? First step, we need to find overlays which we want to use. It could be glitches for transitions or some glare, light leaks or even other clip. It basically just takes the black a background image or a video and make it transparent. So when you overlay it onto your video, it's going to be transparent and the black will go away and everything else is going to be on the top of your video. Let's make some transition with the first glitch overlay. Let's drag it on top of our main clip, and in Video Inspector on the blend mode let's choose Screen. And here you can see that our footage with all their effects became transparent over our clip. Then we can adjust a bit our transition on the timeline to make it more seamlessly. And here another cool method of using overlays. We can add other dynamic effects on our clips with using the overlay. For instance, let's drag Light Leaks footage again on top of our general clip and change our blend mode to Screen. Here we can adjust opacity of our overlay and even make it slower or faster with Command plus R. It's all up to you again, you can add another clip to put it above again and just change its opacity, play with its effects, speed, and after you will understand where and when you can use it. Adjustment layer. Another cool tool which you definitely need in your Final Cut Pro 10. Unfortunately, it isn't in build tool, but specially for you, I put the link in the description to download it. For free, of course. You need to put it to titles in your Final Cut Pro 10 folder. But if you need, you can simply find all instructions of installing in the internet. It's basically empty layer which you can put above your clips and add any kind of effects, additional color grading, transitions, keyframings, movements, anything on it. Personally, I use it all the time in color grading. For instance, if I have a lot of different clips and I want to add one certain cinematic LUT above all of them, I put it on the timeline above all clips, drag on it custom LUT effect which we already know and choose specific LUT which I want to use. And I don't need to use it on each clip. As I said before, you can also do some color grading for all clips on it, add additional effects like Vignette or Transform, Crop, anything. Very useful feature. Stabilization and rolling shutter are enormously powerful tools for each filmmaker. With these tools you can easily fix shake of the camera in your clips or rolling shutter if it is. You can use appropriate method for your situation and type of clip, adjust smoothing in stabilization and amount in rolling shutter. Personally, I use it all the time, especially in weddings and commercial clips. And the final and one of the most powerful tools in Final Cut Pro 10 is keyframing. Keyframing is a tool which exists in almost in any effect, in compositing, transform, cropping. Basically, it is a tool for making animation over the course of some period of time in your videos. But it will be better to show. Here we have transform tool to change the size of our shot. But what if we want to change our size during the whole our clip? In this case, we need to determine our beginning position on the timeline, and at our first frame, we hit this keyframing tool here. Now replay it out for as long as we want to see our cropping and transform our frame in needed size. We can also change the position of our shot or opacity with keyframing tool or effects, anything. We can even add some separate object, PNG file with transparent background and make animation with it in our clip. Let it be camera. We drag it on top of our clip. With transform tool let's change the size. Let's define beginning position of it. Hit this keyframing tool here. Then let's select our final frame on the timeline and move our camera to the right place. In addition, with right click or double click on the moving line, we can change our moving area like this. Or this. Whatever you want. And let's add some effect on it to make it more interesting. Great! Practice a bit and I am assuring you, you'll find a bunch of ways how you can use this tool in your videos. I will know that it's not all cool tricks and effects which you can use in Final Cut Pro 10, right? I understand that. It's just some part of them, my favorite. There are a lot of additional great tools in sound editing, titles, transitions, color grading, and if you want to see more, please let me know in the comments and I promise you I will make another video on it. But that's all for today, guys, and if you like this video, please make sure to give this video a like, don't forget to subscribe, and see you on the next videos. Silhouettes of you are like a taunt. Never really know just what you want.
With you I don't ever feel calm. I can feel the sweat inside my palms. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain of bringing.